We ain't ever satisfied. Matter of fact, you become an addict in the spirit, in the Holy Spirit, in the capital S, Spirit of God. You're addicted. You got to come get your next fix. But modern church is in a hangover state. Somebody say a hangover.
Hangover.
A hangover is the sickness of a drunk. Now, the night before, it was anything but hangover. It was hang out. Come on, man. Boy, couldn't dance, but he didn't care. Come on, somebody. Just let it all hang. Amen. The next morning, hangover in the Oval Office, John's Baptistry, the porcelain throne, and everything in you. Hangover. Somebody say sick. See, hangover Christianity, amen, involves those that are sick of preaching, sick of worship, sick of prayer, sick of revival, sick of always got to have something going on in the church all the time. Pastor don't know when to stop. And I'm sick of going to church all the time. You go to church all the time. They sick of church. They sick of worship. They sick of preaching. Preaching so long. My God, I wouldn't go back when he preaches so long. God. No, you just got to hang on. Somebody shout this in your mouth.
Amen.
Metaphorically, God said being filled with the Spirit. Amen. Glory to God. He uses some contrast here. Amen. About being drunk with wine. He said, which is excess, which is a waste. But be drunk in the Holy Ghost is what he was saying.
Amen.
You know a drunk? They're an addict. They're addicted. And when times are hard, they get drunk. When times is good, they get drunk. You know what hangover Christians do? When times get hard, amen, they stay at the house. They don't come to Joel's bar. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Where new wine's being offered.
Amen.
Oh, glory to God. Anybody hear the Holy Ghost?
Amen.
Hangover Christians, glory to God. Amen. When times get good, amen, instead of coming to the house of God, praise the Son, praise the Lord. Amen. They find an excuse to go somewhere else and celebrate. Somebody looked to around and said, times are hard. Get into God's house. Because the drinks are on the house.
Amen.
There's a divine drink in the Holy Spirit. There's a high like no most high. I ain't talking about Lord Calvary. I'm talking about the Lord of Calvary. I ain't talking about Southern Comfort. I'm talking about the heavenly comfort of Holy Ghost himself. Christians are sick of holiness, sick of living right, because they got a hangover. I tell you what, when you get a fresh drink in the Holy Ghost, and you get drunk in the Holy Ghost again, holiness and living right becomes attractive to you.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. That's a whole other message, fear of God and holiness. Until that hits the church again, there'll be no miracles. Hallelujah. Because if you are, there's only one remedy for a hangover. Get drunk. Joel's bar is on. New wine. Make you smile all the time. Somebody shout, this new wine will deliver you from wine. Make your neighbor say, that shall not be a wine. Honey. Get drunk again. You know, a drunk will give you the shirt off their back. Remember one time I was preaching a street meeting years ago? That's where I started my ministry at. That's why I called it Louisville Public Ministries Incorporated. He made more to God because nobody let me preach in the church. That was one of them moments I got the Holy Ghost, didn't know what else to say. Right, I'm drunk. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I was pretty good, about 50 people sitting out there in the little easy chairs, you know, little chairs out there. Nobody moved. I preach. Finally, out of the dark, when I was receiving an offer, none of the saints moved. I'm talking about they weren't even going to bring me a penny. The saints. Here came this drunk man out of the dark. Well, DJ, it was an hour down the door. I was over by the post office. I don't know who the drunk was. He couldn't even hardly. He was trying to make it to the platform up there, and he couldn't get his bill full out of his pocket. If you just started watching this video now, you need to rewind back up a little bit. Because if you just started watching that, you're about to turn it off and think, man, he's retarded. Who's fooling you? Anyhow, he couldn't get the bill for the last. He walked up there. He pulled a $100 bill out. I was thinking, Lord God, I thought it was a George Washington. You know, he comes to church more than any of them. But thank God for Jonah. He pulled that old Ben Franklin out of there. And he put it in that little jar right there. I said, my Lord, he don't want to give that back. All the Christians didn't he? And here's what he said. Hey, that preacher, if I've been up here in the shadows, I'm there and listening to you. He said, he was picking up that offering. He said, I heard the Lord tell me, can't give it. Now, my God, he didn't hear God. I know what he heard. Because God said, my sheep hear my voice, and they follow me, John 10:27. He just heard the echo. God was telling his saints to do it, but they wouldn't move. And he just heard the echo, and he said, he didn't think care because the drunk could give anything. He wake up the next morning talking about, I can't pay the light bill. Where my money go? He don't care. What happened to the shirt? You dummy, you was so drunk you gave it to somebody. Amen. You know why some saints are sick of giving? They ain't drunk no more. Amen. They got hang-up.
Now, a preacher ever talks about when he gets some pulpits about money. I always have to see an offering about everything. You have a hangover!
Amen.
Come on,
preacher.
Oh, Lord God. How in the world did I get off on this? Talking about an act, a dick. Now listen. Uh-oh. In Proverbs 23, it talks about a man that he gets so drunk that he gets into a fight. Hello? It talks about him being on the sea, too, out and getting seasick. That involves a drunk. They're going to get sick when they get angry. It's what it's talking about. But it talks about him getting in a fight. And not knowing anything about it when he wakes up. Hello? You know, drunk, son. You see that little guy before he gets drunk? He's scared of everybody.
Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
See, some of y'all don't know what I'm talking about, but I don't always say it. I used to look like a toothpick with long hair. I had more hair than my dead body. I promise you, it came down to here. I played my drums for a living. Got paid to do it. Met famous people do it. Hello? And it didn't matter how high we went in that business, in that music business, we always had to go play for drinks. Because if you play the world's music, that's who you're going to, because they're going to support it more than anybody. That's why Budweiser and Jack Daniels and everybody else, come on, somebody's always advertising.
Amen.
For the world's music. Two go together, can't separate them. I don't care. You can't separate them. Two go together. And we were, I remember one night, this guy, he was just quiet, shy, timid, nothing. But son, he got about to haul in him. That dummy, he'd find the biggest man in the house. So somebody say a drunk ain't afraid to fight. You know why some saints ain't willing to fight no more? Stand up for what's right. Every time the devil goes, boo! Stay alert, man. He won't give up with nothing. Hallelujah! They always running from the devil. They always quit because they got to hang up. This little story. It's got some glory. I don't know if it's true or not, but I heard it. And it fits the mystery. It's about a little mouse in the house. Somebody say a mouse in the house. I promise you, you won't forget this. Hallelujah. Praise God. The story of the little mouse in the house was about a drunk man who sat every afternoon in his house at his table home, feeling sorry for himself, with his liquor, and he would drink until he passed out on the table every afternoon. One afternoon, he passed out after getting so drunk. Hey man, his liquor bottle fell over. He began to pour into the floor. Out from the wall, through a little hole, came a little mouse in the house. Looking around for his cheese, and crumbs, anything he could find. The only thing he could find, hey man, was not some crumbs, but some rum. That poured out from this drunk, down on the floor. And the little mouse in the house, he starts to get a close up, Rick. For those ones. Little mouse in the house, he's lapping it up, son. All of a sudden, the little mouse in your house begins his little. Little mouse in the house steps up on his little back leg. Pokes out his little mousey chest. Let me cover my stomach up. I can't do it. I'm stuck. Hey, man. I stuck myself in Mexican. That's why the mouse is Mexican right now. So hold on. Wait, wait. And a little mouse stuck out his little chest. He picks up his little mousey paws. He looks around through the house and says, where is that cat? Somebody's on a delayed shout. They're about to laugh in just a minute when they get it. No words before the little mouse got drunk. He was scared of that cat. But when he got drunk, he stood up. He didn't feel little no more. He like, where that cat at? Bring him to me. I got something for bringing on, Mr. Cat. I'm telling you, when saints get full of the Holy Ghost again and get drunk in the Spirit and addicted to the Holy Ghost and get empty of the stuff and the things of this life, get drunk on the Spirit of God again, they'll stand up when the devil shows up and say, where's that devil? If anybody's leaving, it's going to be here. Yeah.
He's beat up, but he ain't bothered.
You know how Hangover Christianity does?
They offended me. They hurt me. I'm going back to church.
I'm going back there.
Yeah. You get drunk with Holy Ghost, like water beads up on a duck's back. Somebody shout, you get drunk in the Holy Ghost. Christ is in your heart. Chill it don't stay on your shoulder. People so offended over every little thing because they hung over. You get drunk in the Holy Ghost. You're not so easy offended. Stuff. Even those last scriptures.